morning everyone. My name is Vaichandra Mauli. Now I am going to teach about web services and service oriented architecture. That is WSSOA. Means web services, service and service-oriented architecture. So here what you are using web services. So what do you mean by web service? What do you mean by web service? So web service is nothing but it is a communication, means the service which you are providing. We are using distributed computing, right? So here what do you mean by web services? Means the collection of distributed systems into a one system is known as web services, right? The collection of distributed systems into a one system is known as web services. So here we are integrating a number of systems into one system, and this process is known as web services. Right, so here how we are integrating it? By using XML, right? XML means extensible markup language. Right, through XML we will use the code for this XML, or by using this XML code we will process the web services. So here what we are using web services, here what we are doing, we are integrating number of distributed systems into one system. Right? We are integrating number of distributed systems into one system. So next, what we are going to do? What are the uses of it? Right, so what is the use of web service? What is the use of web service means, if the consumer or the customer wants to send any request, right, to the server, so how it will comes? We are communicating using XML. Communication is done using XML, right? Here we have XML namespace, or SOAP, right? These are the uses which you have, right? XML namespace and SOAP. Now, so next, what you are doing? We are going to the basic tools and technologies, right? So here we are going for basic tools and technologies. So what are the basic tools and technologies? XML, right? Two, so three, WSDL, and four, UDDI. Right? These are the basic tools and technologies. So before going to this, first you have to take the architecture of web service, right? Before going into this, you have to go to the architecture of web service. So how it is, architecture of web service, we have service request, service provider, and next service registry. So here what you are doing, first the service request registers for the service. So here what the service request, the consumer, before requesting it, first you have to register for it. Sir, after registering, the provider will check whether the register is present or not, right? So then after the register is been available, he will give the response to the service provider. Then after the service provider has been given this, the client has been given the service provider, it gives that particular service to the requester, right? Understood what I am saying? See, first step is, this is the first step. The service request is being requested by the client to the provider. So what this provider will see, whether it is being registered or not, right? The request which has been given by the client is being registered or not. If it will check in the service registry. In this service registry, whether it is being present or not. If it is present, it gives the response. And the same response is being given to the service request. Right? This is how the architectural process of the web service will go. Right? So now here we will discuss about service request. So what are the main components which you are discussing about service request? So he should follow the XML request pattern. XML request pattern using HTTP or anything. HTTP, you can go with HTML or anything, right? This is the protocol which you are going for the request. Okay, next we are going for the service provider. So here service provider is nothing but the server. Here server also uses the same thing, means XML pattern. XML pattern means whether the service provider which it been considered as the server, and server which you are the request which has been sent by the service request is being considered here. The server will check whether it is been given in the service registry or not. Right? Next, service registry means here it will check whether the service is being registered or not. because there can be some fraud clients also. So to whether to know that whether the it is whether it is a fault client or not, we use this register, right? So if it is being registered, we can go through this, right? This is the architectural process. How it is, the service request is being given to the service provider, and service provider will get that service registry. And the same thing, the service provider, if it is available, the service provider will again give that response to the service request. This is about the architecture of web services, right? So now we are discussing about first thing, XML means extensible markup language, right? So here, extensible markup language, why it is being used? So while you are communicating in the web services, while you are communicating, whether you may be a client or a server, right, you have to use a communication protocol. So this is the communication protocol which you are using. So it can be used as a code. It can be used as a code for communication. Code for communication. So there are previous versions also. Previous versions is HTML. But all the industries prefer XML rather than HTML, right? So all the previous version is about HTML, but all the industries prefer XML rather than HTML. So this is about HTML. Next we have SOAP. SOAP is nothing but simple object access protocol, right? SOAP is nothing but simple object access protocol, and WSDL means Web Services Description Language. Next, UDDL means Universal Discovery Description Language. So after that XML which you are giving, we can have SOAP, that is simple object access protocol. So in this SOAP, what we are doing is we are creating the object for accessing protocols. And the same way, WSDL means Web Services Description Language. So how the web services has been described as a language, that is being considered under the Web Services Description Language. And after that, what the UDDI will do? UDDI means the Universal Discovery Description Language. So here what we are using, we use URLs. URL means Universal Resource Locator. So here we use Universal Resource Locator. So by using this UDDI language is being performed. So this is about this WSS4 web services chapter. Thank you.